Look at the front, where it says Ames real big. All right, everyone, I'm up here in Cleveland, Ohio. I'm at the Beachland Ballroom and Tavern, where I'm about to see my favorite band, all the way from Sweden, from Gothenburg, Sweden. They're playing here, doing a US tour, Dark Tranquillity, a band that I have a lot of mad respect for. You may recognize one of their songs, as it's the intro song to most of my videos. It's off their Atoma album called Force of Hand. Great song, love that song. Anyway, they came back here after a four-year absence because they last toured in 2018, then they wrote a new album, and then COVID hit. And because of that, they had to put touring on hold. And actually, they were supposed to be here in 2021, but that tour got canceled because of a crappy promoter that got accused of, I think it was sexual harassment or sexual assault anyway, which is no good. And I respect the band for dropping him as a result. But they're back here with a new promoter. I've been talking to the guys for a little while here before the show started. We've been here since 3 o'clock. The doors don't even open till 7. And we were hanging out with them, getting our pictures with them, autographs. They gave us a poster, a pic, and a couple guitar picks and stuff, and we're ready for them. And, you know, they got a new promoter, as they were saying, and they've been to a lot of new venues, including this one, because normally they would play at Agora Theater, but that's okay. I'm really happy to see this place and go inside and excited, so I get to show you guys my favorite band. And opening acts for this show is Kataklysm and Nailed to Obscurity. I think they're in the other order as to when they play, but either way, it's a great lineup. I'm very excited, and I'm just happy to see my favorite band back here in the States. I'm all decked out in my DT gear. I'm even rocking the shirt from the last tour, so I'm ready. Kayla's in the car right now, charging up her phone, as it's a little chilly out here, but me being a mad Dark Tranquillity fan and a huge Die Hard fan, I had to be the first one in line, and she respected that. That was how she was with her favorite bands when we went to see Deer and Gray and the Gazette, so it's my turn, and I get to show you guys the band who makes the intro for my videos. Well, they wrote it as a song, and I used it for the videos, and they said they were cool with it. I talked to them about that, and they said they felt honored that we do that, so that's cool. Look at this, the tavern sign just lit up. That's pretty cool. Now we're just waiting for that one to light up. But anyway, I'm ready for a heavy metal night here in Cleveland, Ohio, and then Wednesday we get to do it again in Pittsburgh when they come that way, so whew, can't wait. The Beachland Ballroom and Tavern, really nice place. I already got a poster, met the band. And they're back over here. Their tour bus is over here. Kayla's, like I said, sitting in the car. But that's Dark Tranquillity's tour bus back there behind the Z24. And soon we'll be inside enjoying some metal. Oh, yeah, that looks good up there. That neon looks pretty good. I like that. Ready to go inside here. I'll see you inside the Beachland Ballroom. When you're first in line, you get rewarded by being first at the front row, like me. Perfect, perfect spot. I love that drum kit. That drum kit looks amazing. I wish I could go up there and play it. I love drums. I'm a percussionist. I have my drum kit. I'm gonna be getting that moment flag back there. That's badass. They have it at their merch table. All right, so the hall already. The personalized drum head drawn by them and autographed by all the members of Dark Tranquillity. The ball cap. I had to get the ball cap. That is badass. I have the beanie. You may have seen it in some of my videos. The new shirt with the tour dates on the back. Here I got the flag, which you see back there on that amp. Now you'll see a better picture of it later, but yeah. Gotta support my favorite band. Especially since it cost them a lot of money to come over from Sweden to the United States to tour. I love these guys. I got a great deal of respect for them. Gotta support them.
Thank you. Noise.
Yeah!
Thank you so much.
Woo!
DT!
DT! DT! DT! DT! DT! DT! DT! DT! DT! Yeah! Okay, now that you got to see a snippet of what we got to experience in Cleveland, let me show you the haul that we got from not just the Cleveland show, but the Pittsburgh one as well. Now, you haven't seen anything from the Pittsburgh concert yet, but you'll see that in part two of this video. But in the meantime, let me show you the haul that we got from the concert. And no, we did not get the cat with everything as much as I wish, but we've had her a lot longer than that, and she's just adorable. Anyway, let me show you what we ended up getting. You know, when you have some really amazing bands come through the States here, some really amazing talent with Nailed to Obscurity from Germany, Kataklysm from Canada, Dark Tranquillity from Sweden. For me, I like to be able to support the bands, and since Dark Tranquillity is my favorite band of all time, I go overboard and spend hundreds of dollars on their merchandise. And, we wanted to get something from everybody, basically, because all three bands were great, and boy, did we have a lot of fun. Let me get started over here. This was their tour shirt that I ended up getting at Cleveland, when you might have seen it at the beginning of the video. On the back, it has the tour dates from the concert, from the whole U.S. tour. And, yeah, as you can see here, the Cleveland one was on March 6th there. And then the Pittsburgh one was just a few days later on March 9th, North American Moments Tour. And that's off their new album, anyway. And you might have seen I got two flags. I didn't just get one. I got two. I got one with the initial intent of putting one up at work and having another one for home. But I've decided that I'd rather just have both of them at home. But we'll see what happens. But the difference is I got just a regular one here. And then this one, well, it was a regular one when I bought it. But with us hanging out with all the members of Dark Tranquillity, they were honored enough to sign this flag, all the members of Dark Tranquillity, Michael Stani, Chris Amott, Johan Reinholds, Joachim, and where's Martin? Martin's on here. And then we had Mike Bear, who was filling in from the United States, because Anders, their old bassist, left the band with COVID going on. And it was a peaceful exit, no hard feelings. And he's very much still loved and respected among the band, and he just decided he wanted to pursue other things, such as the case with Anders, their drummer. After being with the band since the beginning of it, he decided he wanted to move on as well. Again, they respectfully let him go, and there's no hard feelings, and he's still very much a friend and family member of Dark Tranquillity. But Joachim, the drummer from this band called In Mourning, filled in. He was fantastic, and rumor has it he's going to be the new drummer now for Dark Tranquillity. I really hope so. And Mike Bear, who's from the other side of the United States, he was only filling in on the tour, but since he was very much a part of Dark Tranquillity, I wanted him to sign this flag too, because he was just as much a vital part of making this band what it is. So happy to have every member sign it. We ended up getting a couple of Nailed to Obscurity t-shirts. I got one. Kayla got one as well. Really awesome. We did not get the cat with the concert, though Leah's just a precious little girl. She meowed and nothing came out. I had the new Moment album from Dark Tranquillity, and I had the three members that actually were on the album sign it, which was Chris Amott, Johan, and Michael. I couldn't get Martin's autograph on it, unfortunately, because he was out and about when I had this out. But I did get to hang out with him after the Cleveland and after the Pittsburgh shows. I ended up getting the baseball cap, Kataklysm's new CD. We got two set lists from Kataklysm, one from the Cleveland show, one from the Pittsburgh show, even though their set lists were the same. The poster from the Cleveland show up there in the Beachland Ballroom. Then we got two set lists from Dark Tranquillity, one from the Cleveland date, as indicated up there. And if you're a Dark Tranquillity fan, how about that? All the members that performed signing that. But I mean, how about that set list? And if you thought that was good, especially Punish My Heaven, which they've never played, this one here, Letha, how about that? Free card. Really, really great, great set list. again, Punish My Heaven, and even The Lesser Faith, another song that I love. But one of my favorites on there, on both of them, being Atoma and The Treason Wall. Excellent songs, and they signed that one as well. You already saw the drum head from the beginning of the video where Michael Yoakum and everybody signed it. They drew this up, they signed it, and I thought it was really cool because I'd never seen this before, and I paid a little bit of money for it, but it was for a great band, a great, humble group of guys. Had to have it. One of a kind, the only one like this, and I thought it was badass. Happy to be the proud owner of this thing. So I was very fortunate to have that happen. Kayla got the old school Dark Tranquillity t-shirt here. Really like that one. I have the same one somewhere. I have so many Dark Tranquillity shirts, but I have the same one. That's such a badass t-shirt. Really good decision. And we were fortunate enough to get a bunch of sticks and guitar picks. Ended up getting a drumstick from Dark Tranquillity's drummer, Yoakum. After he used it, he handed it directly to me, and then he signed it. Something as being a drummer myself, I really love when they are able to sign the drumsticks. And the drummer from Kataklysm got a stick from him as well, and he signed it as well. So, very, very cool. And then we ended up getting a bunch of guitar picks. We have more that we have them laying around somewhere. I think they're in the Cavalier. But we ended up getting guitar picks from both Johan and Chris Amott. So, see Johan and his signature on the back there, and then Chris Amott. And we, like I said, we have more, but that's just the tip of the iceberg with those guitar picks. We have a bunch more, but yeah, pretty good haul. I'd say a lot of money was spent, but I have to support my bands because this is where they make their money on tours. It costs them a lot of money to come over here to the States to tour. Visas for members of Dark Tranquillity, Martin was telling me, costs upwards of $1,100 per person. And you figure there's a bunch of members in the bands, stage crew, sound guys, everybody that makes it possible. So, want to support my favorite group out there. Really thankful for an awesome, awesome tour. Two wonderful shows. You'll see the Pittsburgh one in the next video. And just can't wait to do this again. And they have said that they're shooting to come back to the United States in fall of this year or early spring next year, which would be about a year from now, which is what they typically do. You know, whether they come back in the fall or spring, we will absolutely be there. I won't miss them at all. I was there right after my dad died. They came to the United States 2 weeks after my father passed away in 2016, and that one really hit hard for me. I'll talk to you more a little bit about that in the next episode, but yeah, pretty good haul. Really happy, and can't wait to do it again. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this one. Stay tuned for part two from the Pittsburgh show, which took place over at the Craft House. Great venue, great people. And by the way, the people at the Beachland Ballroom, one of the best venues I've ever been to. The sound was okay, but the people there were super nice. It was a nice establishment, really felt welcome. They let you go in and out of the venue if you wanted, because with all this merchandise, they let me run it out to the car so I wouldn't have to hold it the entire time. And they were very, very friendly. Definitely 5-star venue, really like them a lot. In the Craft House too, but I'll talk about that in the next episode. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, stay awesome, and have a Dark Tranquillity delicious day. Boy, that's a hard one to do, but we got it. Talk to you later, everybody. Bye-bye.